Hey, everybody, breathe in.
Breathe in.
Sound tables setup check.
And out.
The flats are secure check.
And breathe in.
Breathe in.
This flat is still wet.
And out.
This flat is wet.
Mr. Taylor is just working on it.
And one more time, breathe in.
I'm getting dizzy.
What was wrong?
He said the trees weren't right.
Tell the castle to be on the set. Does everything have to happen on opening night?
Okay, that was great, everybody. Now we're going to be a tiny seed.
Amber's making us do the seed thing.
Who's leading these warm-ups anyways?
I'll do anything but the seed.
Mr. O'Neill.
Come on, Doug. It can't be that bad.
Do I look like a seed to you?
Doug King, my very special sources have told me that Keanu Reeves did this very same exercise every night before he performed Hamlet. If Keanu Reeves could do it, so can you.
Mr. O'Neill,
just do the seed thing, Doug.
Now we are going to be a tiny seed.
I'm doing this under protest.
We're going to start at the beginning of life, and then we're going to grow and stretch our arms out tall and strong. When we're done, we are going to be a forest of trees. Okay, first we have to crouch very low.
I've never been a seed before.
And then we have to straighten our legs out. Slowly, gracefully, think like a tree, everybody.
Do I look like a tree?
Be quiet, dog.
You can't think like any tree. You have to pick a tree. What type of tree are you?
Do you know how to think like a tree, Mr. O'Neill?
I have enough trouble thinking like a person.
I'm an oak tree. I'm an oak tree.
What is that doing?
That was great, everybody. I would like you to all know that I was a willow tree. Okay, everybody, shake it out.
Shake it out.
Loosen your arms and legs.
I'm loose.
What are you doing?
I'm warming up.
The crew doesn't have to warm up, Mark.
Why?
Because
why?
Because we don't. We just don't.
Okay, everybody, you're loose. You're warm. Nobody can stop you now. Have a great show.
Has anyone seen my cigarettes? What have I done with them?
Quit, Mr. O'Neill.
Oh, right. What a dumb thing to do.
What's the matter, Mr. O'Neill? You seem a little nervous.
I just want the show to be flawless tonight.
Why?
An old friend of mine is coming. He used to be a professional stage manager.
A professional stage manager?
That's right, so you better do a good job.
I better do a good job.
What are those apple blossoms?
I have to put them on the tree.
The professional tree has far too many as it is. The actors are going to hit their heads.
The professional stage manager is coming to see me.
Mr. Thompson had a dream last night. The show bombed because there weren't enough apple blossoms.
Why would a show bomb because of the number of flowers on a tree?
I'm going to be a professional stage manager.
You'll have to ask him.
I'm going to be famous. A famous stage manager.
Where is our director anyway? Has anyone seen Mr. Thompson?
See?
I'm not dressed like a famous stage manager. I have to change.
He's practicing the guitar. Of course he's practicing the guitar. We go on in an hour and he's practicing the guitar.
Classical guitar.
Well, thank God it's classical.
Do you want me to go look for him?
No, I'll have Mark go look for him. Mark?
Do you want me to go look for Mark too?
Just don't get lost. I'm running this show by myself.
I can see the headlines now. Missing one stage crew. They disappeared one by one down the underground passage.
You're giving me the creeps.
Was it Mr. Thompson in the dressing room with the lead pipe? Mr. Sharp in the underground passage with the conductor's baton.
Cut it out, Doug. Julie, go look for Mark.
By myself?
There's no one in the underground passage, Julie.
That's why I called it the dungeon, right, Mr. O'Neill?
Thanks, Doug.
No problem.
Julie, we're running out of time. Go look for Mark.
Fine. But if I get killed, my mother's not going to be very happy.
Hey, this flat is wet.
Don't touch that. Mr. Taylor was putting some finishing touches on the trees.
That's good. They looked like bushes yesterday.
let me just check you guys off.
Doug, do you know where your sister is? She missed the warm-ups and she's not going to be prepared for the show.
Beth is missing?
I never miss a warm-up.
Anne of Green Gables will be a little short if we don't have an Anne.
She's here. Mr. Thompson wanted something done with her wig. I think they're in the dressing room.
Here, I have to go talk to our director about these apple blossoms.
Is Mr. O'Neill okay? He seems nervous. More nervous than we are. Not that I'm nervous.
Some manager friend of his is coming tonight. Manager friend? Manager?
As an agent? That kind of manager?
As in an acting agent?
I guess so.
I didn't know Mr. O'Neill knew any agents. Why didn't he tell me? Who do you think he's coming to see?
Why don't we go ask him?
Well, if it's supposed to be a surprise, I don't want to spoil anything.
I don't want to be surprised. I want to know.
Tara! Look what Mr. Thompson did to my wig! Holy cow! He thought it needed a little more color.
A little color?
You can stop traffic with that wig.
I can't go on stage with this.
Peter. Wait till the agent gets a load of you.
Agent? What agent? He's a friend of Mr. O'Neill's. That's why Mr. O'Neill's so nervous.
I've got the lead.
You just run around. There's nothing harder than that.
I've been taking singing lessons.
That's because you sing like a sick moose.
I'm telling Mom you said that.
Better not, or else I'm going to kiss you on stage.
I don't care if you're playing Gilbert. If your lips come anywhere near my lips, I'll hit you so hard you see the backside of your head.
Kissy, kissy, kissy.
I can't wait.
Aw, sisterly love, so touching.
Mark, why are you dressed like that?
What are you telling me, Dougie? What is it?
Dougie.
It's all very hush, hush.
Hush, hush.
That's right.
That top hat's for the show.
Always remember the little people.
Ow! What are you still doing on stage? Get to the dressing rooms.
Did you find Mr. Thompson?
Someone saw him in the parking lot about an hour ago, but now he's nowhere to be found.
We can't go on without Mr. Thompson.
You don't... Yes, we can. You don't want to get to the show now, do you?
That's right. We don't want to disappoint the agent.
That's right, Beth. That's right. The show has to go on.
The show must go on. Right.
The house is opening. They're letting the audience in. What are you guys still doing on stage?
Everybody off!
We're on our way. Don't worry, Mr. O'Neill. We're gonna do a great job.
That's right! A great job!
Well, good.
Oh, why do they make sunglasses so dark?
Why did I pick this week to quit smoking?
Different.
Are you kidding? I was great.
Tamara, are you feeling okay?
I'm fine. Thank you. Yes, it was very hard work. Yes,
what are you doing?
Nothing.
All the actors are acting so weird tonight.
Why do I have to pull the rope? I think real famous stage managers want to touch rope.
Everybody's acting weird.
It's just opening night jitters. You never know who's going to be out in the audience.
Watch out for the... Ow! Too late.
things are going well, don't you think?
Mr. Thompson should be very pleased. Did you ever find him?
I found his guitar.
I hope he's watching the show.
Have any of the actors just the set?
The trees are fully intact.
Julie, I need to hide, I need to hide.
What's the matter?
You never saw me.
Doug!
You never saw me.
Doug,
hey.
Shh! Be quiet, don't move.
Where is that scum-sucking slime?
Keep your voice down.
That dastardly deserter.
What's going on?
That crate.
You're in trouble.
Shh.
What happened?
Doug, how could you?
There you are.
I didn't do anything wrong.
Yes, you did.
Right in the middle of the show.
I just wanted to see other people.
I didn't mean it.
Did you have to go right in the middle of the show?
How's I meant to know that?
It was just about.
Does the phrase "we're in the middle of the show" mean anything to you guys?
I need to get out of here.
Great idea, but you get out of here.
Okay.
Not you, Mark.
I'll just be in the dressing room.
Back here, I'm not finished.
Don't go far, you're on soon.
My parents are here tonight.
The nerve of some people.
I need a smoke.
It's okay, Mr. Neal. I don't think anybody in the audience heard.
We're up to the tea party. How are they doing?
Bright as rain, I think.
Now what's the matter?
I'm sure it's nothing.
Julie, tell me what's happening on stage.
It's just I've never seen Tamara wave her arms like that.
Is that all a little arm flail? She's just being creative, that's all.
You're absolutely right. She's just being expressive.
Oh! Aren't we having a lovely tea party? Yes, we are. It's so lovely.
Mr. O'Neill?
Those lines aren't in the script.
I said to myself, wouldn't this be a lovely day for a tea party? And lo and behold, here we are having tea. Yes, two cups. One for me, Diana, and one for you, Anne. That's right. I'm Diana, and you're Anne.
What are you doing?
I can't find the wig.
What?
What? I can't.
A lovely thing tea is. I try to have at least 15 cups a day.
I can't find it.
Keep stalling, Tamara.
I love tea. Do you love tea?
That's
green
right.
Tea, orange tea, all types of tea are great.
She's got the wig.
She's got the wig.
Thank goodness. For tea, that is. Thank goodness for tea.
Good job, Tamara.
wig on.
Anne, do you want more tea? I want some more tea. Keep stalling, Tips. Keep stalling. I like having tea from the kettle. I don't know about you. It's just so much more fresher.
She's almost there.
Anne, do you agree with me? She's done that great.
Goodness.
Oh.
I'm sorry, Diana. I just fell for a moment.
Oh, Anne. Oh, my.
Are you ready for another cup of tea, Diana?
Yes, this play is going very smoothly.
Very smooth indeed.
How's it going out there? It's the most unbelievable thing I've ever seen in my life.
That's good.
Sort of. Good luck.
Ow!
Watch out for the apple blossoms!
What is it? My flashlight just went out. The batteries are dead. I don't believe this. I can't see the script. I can't cross the stage. The audience will see me. I can't see the script. How can I do the sound cues if I can't see the script? Don't panic. Don't panic. Mark.
Yes, Mr. O'Neill.
Take those sunglasses off, Mark.
Oh, there you are.
I need you to bring my flashlight to the sound guy.
Okay.
You're okay with that? You know you can't cross the stage because the audience will see you.
No problem, Mr. O'Neill.
Great.
Mr. O'Neill.
Mark's coming with the flashlight.
What?
Mark is coming with the flashlight.
I can't hear you.
Mark is coming with the flashlight.
Oh, why didn't you say so?
Mr. O'Neill.
Back already? That was quick.
How do I do it?
Do what?
How do I get to the other side of the stage?
Are you telling me you haven't gone yet?
Where's the flashlight?
I can't go across the stage. The audience will see me. I went to the back. There's no back way. I went to the underground passage. Let's go to the dressing rooms.
Oh, Mark, are you telling me after all we've been rehearsing for months, are you telling me that after all this time you didn't realize you can't get the stage left from the inside?
You can't?
No.
There's no back way.
No.
Or a dumb design. We should talk to somebody about that. Principal or something.
I need the flashlight.
We're coming, Mark, you have to go outside.
Outside?
Flashlight.
Yes, Mark, go out that door, around the back, and bring the flashlight to the sound guy.
Outside?
I got a cue coming up. I can feel it.
You can't see the script. It's the only way.
But it's January.
It's the only way.
But it's January.
If you run really fast, you won't feel a thing.
Can I pretend to be a bush or a tree or something? The audience will never know.
Go now. Go now. Go now.
I have the stage manager to know that I'm risking my life here.
$10 to get lost in the parking lot.
Come on, Julie. Positive thinking.
$20 to get lost.
Maybe he'll find Mr. Thompson.
What's happening, Mr. O'Neill?
Mark's coming with the flashlight.
What?
Mark is coming with the flashlight.
I can't hear you.
Mark, forget it.
Here. Well, finally.
Hope you appreciate this.
It doesn't work either.
Sure it does.
Be quiet over there.
It doesn't work.
Maybe it only works on the right side of the stage.
You're gonna have to get me another one.
No way. I'm not going back up there. It's January.
But I can't see the script.
Here, you can light it.
Why can't I have a light?
You never know. We're gonna come across sound guys and dead flashlights. Here, hold it for me.
Help!
That didn't sound like an apple blossom. Ow.
Cheryl fell. I can't walk.
What do you mean you can't walk?
I can't walk. She hurt her ankle. I hurt my ankle. I slipped on an apple blossom.
Of course you can walk. Just walk.
What are we gonna do if she can't walk stage with a hurt ankle?
Julie, you play your part.
Me?
She can't do my part.
I could if I wanted to.
If she does my part, that agent will never hire me.
What agent?
She's delirious.
I'll never become a famous actress and I'll have to work at McDonald's for the rest of my life.
Be quiet, all of you. Beth, I need you to go backstage and see if your brother and some of the other guys can carry her off stage.
Doug's hiding.
Go drag him out.
Okay.
I need you to go find some ice.
All right.
Do we have any crutches in the storage room?
I don't think so.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure.
What am I going to do?
Okay, Julie, I need you to look out in between the flats very carefully.
Okay.
Okay, I want you to look out very carefully and very slowly. I want you to see...
I thought I saw my mother.
Come here, hold her.
What are you doing?
Looking for a cane.
In the audience?
Maybe someone will let us borrow it till the end of the show.
I can't walk.
Think of your character, Cheryl. Marilla wouldn't give up this easily. No, she's got spunk. She's got nerve. She's got a will of iron.
But she never had a sprained ankle.
She does now.
Okay, everyone needs to come over here. Look out in between the flats very carefully. Very slowly. Your mother has sharp eyes.
I think I saw one in the second row.
Second row?
On the left.
On the left. Voila!
How are we gonna get it?
You're gonna go to the man very politely at intermission and ask if we can borrow his cane for a good show.
What if he says no?
Then grab it and run off.
I'm not gonna do that.
Then I will.
You're not going to steal his cane, are you? If you take his cane under false pretenses, I won't go on.
I won't steal his cane, I promise.
Promise?
Feel better?
Thank you.
Quiet over there.
The script is on fire!
What? I told you not to hold the lighting so close.
The script is on fire!
Do something.
What are you thinking, huh?
One more minute. The show is almost over. We've almost finished the show and nobody died.
No, stage on fire.
You stage on fire.
I hate theater.
Everybody's bowing, they're clapping. It looks like Doug and Cheryl are back together.
Cheryl held them down during intermission.
Thank God.
That could have been a disaster. Gilbert might not have lost a limb or something during one of the production numbers.
I'm never becoming a famous stage manager.
It's your own fault.
I hate theater.
You had one job.
You had one single job. You had to lay a rope across the stage, and you forgot.
How was I to know that I was caught on the carrot field?
One single job.
How was I to know I was running too fast?
I have 1,000 jobs, and you have one.
How was I to know I was running too fast, and the rope got caught, ripping off every single layer of my sacred skin, and I had to drink my hands in the act of drinking water?
Don't exaggerate.
I hate theater.
The curtain's coming down. We almost finished the show.
It was a piece of cake.
Oh, it's easy for you to say.
I hate theater.
It was your own fault. How did you forget to lay out the rope if you spent all that time coiling it?
I don't know. Something wrong with my sunglasses.
Like what?
Someone made them too dark. Yeah, that's it. Oh. I'm thinking music next trimester.
We did it, and it's over.
All finished. Now sit there and don't move. And try not to set the whole school on fire.
Oh, we finally finished the show.
Ow, ow, ow!
Everyone's winking at you. Why was she winking at
she
you?
She wasn't winking. There was stuff in her eye.
What were you doing so close to her eye?
Doug and Cheryl were having a little spat.
That was quick.
They did wait till the curtain went down.
You have to be pretty close to see fluff into somebody's eye. It's good the agent can't see this. They never take up with this type of behavior.
Cheryl, you need to calm down.
There wasn't any fluff.
So now you're lying to me, are you?
No fluff.
You should
no
try
fluff.
Yoga. It's always on me. Hey, Cheryl, try this.
So now you're lying to me?
No fluff.
Enough! We have 2 more shows to do, and I don't want to spend up keeping the 2 of you apart.
We're just working out our problems, Mr. O'Neill.
Working out?
If you have problems, then work them out someplace else, like Tahiti. This show is over, both of them. I'll see you tomorrow and get your costumes and makeup off as fast as you can. Ah!
That's it? Maybe there really wasn't an agent.
No, I swear I saw somebody writing things down.
I'm sorry, I was just a little stressed tonight.
A little stressed.
Well, with the agent coming in all?
The agent. Shh.
Don't ask him.
You ask him.
I'm going home. Agent or no agent? Mr. O'Neill! Mr. O'Neill!
I'll let him shrink and I won't be able to act.
Yes, Beth.
Do you think you're a friend like the show?
My friend?
Your friend, the one in the audience.
Oh, I don't know. I'll have to talk to him.
Do you think he wants to talk to any of us?
I mean, I don't think so. He doesn't know any of us.
Right, guys. He doesn't know any of us, right?
Right.
Right.
Well,
you guys are nuts.
I'll see you guys tomorrow.
My nasal passages are drying up.
Miss Cornelia, wait.
We want to know.
We don't want to be surprised.
Who's he here for?
Who do you want to see?
What are you talking about?
The agent.
I don't know any agents.
What about your friend in the audience, the manager?
The acting manager.
That manager.
The stage manager, Beth. What used to be a stage manager?
Stage manager?
Stage manager?
Stage manager? You said he was an acting manager.
An agent.
Oops.
So he wasn't interested in our acting at all?
That's right. He was here for me. I'm going to be a famous stage manager.
Oh, no, you're not.
Yes, I am. Mr. O'Neill said that there was a stage manager here, and I thought I'd do a good job.
That's because you always screw up, Mark.
Oh, that's different then. Someone help me up.
So there's no agent?
No, he's an old friend of mine. I've known him for years. Besides, he's not a stage manager anymore. Now he's a biology teacher.
A biology teacher?
Yeah, he was just here to see the show.
That's what's been going on all evening? You guys thought you were gonna be famous?
Oh, there's no need to laugh.
You were making total fools of yourself.
We made total fools.
We made fools out of ourselves for nothing.
Well, that wasn't very hard for you, Beth.
At least I wasn't battling about fluff.
Shut up.
You shut up.
Shut up.
I'm going to be a famous stage manager.
I thought you hated the theater.
I do. But I still want to be a famous stage manager.
There's no such thing as a famous stage manager.
How do you know?
Name me one famous stage manager.
I'll be the first then.
Ha! You'll never be a stage manager. Little famous one. Yeah!
My friend was right. Stage managing is way too stressful. From now on, I'm going to direct.